My kitchen is on fire.
Hey y'all, it's the Fit.
I made a few changes from last time because I saw some of the things that I didn't do right. Like, I shut the salon door because my mom is working, so you won't hear her. I don't have a tripod, but my water bottle has like a thing on the handle where you can put a cup or a phone. And so hopefully that works. But yeah, today we're going to be, there's two, but I don't think I have the stuff for the one. So we're just going to make bagels. Bagels are super easy. It's like a few ingredients and then they're like versatile, so you can make whatever kind. So I'm gonna make everything jalapeno cheddar and like cinnamon crunch Panera bagels. I'm gonna try to do this. And also shout out to my cousin Jonathan. He made the new logo and the new intro picture, so it's pretty bust, but yeah. I need to stop hiding out in my parents' room. But, what is it? Tamron Hall. She's always on. Let's just turn it off. Okay. Let me get out the recipe and all the ingredients, and then I'll tell you what you need. Like, look at how good this is. You won't be able to see. But this is set up good. I wasn't at all like planning to do this. That's why I didn't go to the store for like anything. But I'm like basically home alone right now. Other than my mom's working, but like she's busy. I've never seen MTV. But
okay. I wrote it down. I'll post a picture right here. So you can get that out and then, or you can just follow me.
Okay, these are all the ingredients with like the bagel and the topping that you're gonna need. One egg. Okay, to start, you're gonna do 2/4 cups. No, that's not right. 2 cups plus 1/4 cup of warm water. Okay, can't remember. 1.5 tablespoons of active dry yeast. That's either, so like mine, it comes in a jar.
Like this.
So I'll use like the measuring spoon, but if not, you just buy the active dry yeast packets and it's just one packet. And then 1 tablespoon of sugar. The sugar, for those who don't know, yeast is like alive, like it's an organism. And you have to feed it so that it blooms and does what yeast is supposed to do. So you add sugar and it eats it and then it does what it gives what it should have gave. None of my, like I have these, but they're not going to fit 2 1/4 because they only fit 2 cups. Let me find something. This one's bigger, so I think this will work. Okay, so I have my 2 1/4 cups of warm water. My hands are clean, I promise. Like, it doesn't work, because you can't see anything on the table. Let me scoot it back. Let me see if that works. Technical difficulties. And then I'm gonna pause this. Let me move everything out of the way. I think I also lied to you about how much a packet is. 1 tablespoon's actually a lot, plus 1.5 tablespoons. So I think you need to just read the directions or like the stuff on the back to make sure that you have enough. But so, okay. I'll show you what the yeast looks like.
Can you see?
Yeah. Just like that.
And then we'll add the sugar, and then you're gonna let it sit for 10 minutes.
Okay, so you can see this is now mixed in. So on the top, it kind of like, you can hear it kind of crackle a little bit. You can't. And then the like water is kind of cloudy.
You'll just let that sit with a wet paper towel over top of it for 10 minutes. I also forgot to mention, I'm using a stand mixer because two of the bagels I'm doing like mixing stuff into the batter. Or the dough, whatever.
It's so pretty.
So if you don't have one, you can just knead with your hands. It'll just be exhausting, but like you can. But I'm not.
Okay, so while we wait for this to finish blooming, I'm using the bowl of my mixer, and then I'm gonna mix all the dry. So you're gonna use 5 cups of flour, 2 teaspoons of sea salt, and then 3 tablespoons of packed brown sugar.
When it's packed, it just means that you like press it into the tablespoon so that it like packs in so you get more. I know last video I had said that some recipes called for packed. This one does, so just do that.
Okay, so now I have the 3 in there, and then I'm going to use a spatula to just mix it together. So you're just going to mix it all together. I'll be back.
Okay, I have a confession, the spatula didn't work. So I'm using a whisk, just so I can break up. Because when you pack the brown sugar, like, you have to, like, unpack it to mix it in good. So the whisk works the best. But yeah, now you have your mixture. This isn't even the right spatula. This is the one that I like. My favorite. I used it last video. Oh, I didn't film a wash your hands segment. She shut the door. Okay, good. We're good. Now, now that you have your stuff mixed. Dang.
Hold on. The yeast has bloomed a lot. That's what you want it to do. Okay, now I'm just gonna dump that in. It's gross, I know. And then use the spatula to mix it until like a good dough forms. I'll show you what that looks like.
Okay, so this is what the dough looks like now. It's like formed.
So now you're gonna put it in the stand mixer if you have one, or you're gonna pull it out of the bowl onto a floured surface and knead it for like 10 to 15 minutes.
Okay, so you're gonna put that in, and then if you have this, you're gonna put that on. And then I start slow. You want to make sure it's kneading. And then you can turn it up once it all starts. And then it'll start to like grab it better. And then you're just going to do this for 10 to like 15. You can use a spatula to like push it better. But make sure you turn it off, because I about like broke some fingers when I did those ones. So I'll be back in 10 minutes. And I'll show you what the dough will look like once it's all kneaded and good. Okay, so while that's mixing, I just did all the dishes so far. I put away the things I don't need. And then now I'm going to start prepping for... That was an accident. I'm going to prep for all the, like, fillings or the toppings. There's only 2 weeks to go. So I'll show you what I'm doing once I get it. And already 4 minutes in, it looks really good. I'm just going to, like... So the first thing I'm doing is I'm getting the jalapenos ready.
what I'm doing is I'm gonna take a paper plate with some paper towel and I'm gonna dry them out so that they don't make the dough super wet and gross on the inside, because it can turn them green. It's happened to me before. But so yeah, we're just gonna take some paper towel. Put it on the plate, and then I'm gonna put the jalapenos on, and then I'm gonna flip this part over and then press it with my hands and just let it sit for a little bit. These are all the ones I'm gonna do because I'm making 3 flavors. And so yeah, you just press it. Use the extra to press it. And just let that sit and wash your hands, because that's gross. Okay, now that I have the jalapenos crushing, the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the topping for the cinnamon crunch bagel. So I'm gonna use brown sugar, cinnamon, and sugar. I think that'll work. Let's see. I've never made one before like that.
I could look it up, but I like to make life difficult. So we're not gonna. And I lied when I said that I was putting mix-ins into 2 bagels. I'm only doing 1, because for the cinnamon crunch bagel I was gonna put cinnamon in it, but now that the dough's formed, I don't think I can put cinnamon in that and mix it good. So I'm just gonna mix the 1.
Quick, just step on the gas, 'cause I don't wanna miss this. See what you're bringing me, boy, it's priceless. I gotta be out of my mind not to try this. Through strength I found love, in time I found myself, in happiness with you. Through strength I found love,
sugar. I think that'll get like the crispy and the crunchy like the Panera ones do. I hope. So we'll see. But so then I have the jalapenos, that, and then now I'm done for the prepping. I'm just waiting for the dough to finish. It's been 10 minutes and this is super like, this is what you want it to be like. Okay, so here's the dough. I'm gonna lightly flour the, or no, I'm just gonna use parchment paper because I don't want to add any more flour to this. But so you're gonna flip this out onto parchment paper, and then for me, I'm gonna divide the dough into 3 equal sections, and then one of them I'm gonna put back into here. So I'll show you in a sec. Okay, here's the bagel dough. If you can do this, it's good because it's not super sticky. And this is what you want. So I just kind of flatten it out a little bit so that I can cut it easier. So this is how I have it. And then I use a bench scraper. I have this non-stick one that I use, so let me... Okay, and you're just gonna... I think that looks good. So you're just gonna cut it. And then I'm gonna take this one and just put it back in. Okay, I'm having an epiphany.
So that's like not a ton of dough. I'm thinking about combining the jalapeno cheddar and the everything and doing a savory and like a sweeter, so I can make more of each flavor. Okay, we'll do it. Bye.
Bye. Have a great day.
You too. So now I have that in there, and then I'm going to cut these up into small chunks, and then I'm going to add these with some cheddar cheese into that, and then mix it. I'll show you what it looks like. That should be my, like, motto, because I feel like I say that every 5 seconds.
I'll show you what it looks like.
Okay, I cut mine, like, small, because I wanted them to be everywhere. So now just add them. Okay, so I have those in there, and then now I'm taking, I had sharp cheddar, but there wasn't enough. I thought that would have been good, but I'm just gonna use mild. That's enough. Okay, so now that I have the cheese and the jalapenos, we're gonna, let me rearrange. Oh yeah, let's take a Riley pause. She's on her period. Yeah. Okay, back to it. I'm just trying to get some of it a little pre-mix so that it picks it all up. There we go.
So that's what it looks like right now. I'm gonna let that knead really good so that it all is, like, deep in the bagel and stuff.
I'm really happy with how this turned out. Okay, so this is the jalapeno cheddar one. You can see it's, like, all mixed in, and then this is just the plain one. Okay, so this part is gonna take about 30 minutes because you have to let it rest twice. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna cut this up into equal balls. I'll tell you how many I cut mine into, and then you're gonna let them rest as in, like, their ball, and then the second time you're gonna form, like, the bagel, and then you're gonna let it sit for another 15 minutes. And then I'll go through the next step after that. I guess I should show you how I do this. But so I have these 5, and then I cut mine, just chop it up with this. I think you can see that. And then you just roll them. Once you have all these done, you're gonna cover them with a towel and let them sit for 15 minutes. And then the next time we do something, then I'll show you the next step. My last one I felt like was funnier than this. This one's all just informational. Which I guess is, like, the whole purpose, but, like, it's gotta be entertaining. Let me think of something. So, I have a plan. I've planned out 6 episodes that I'm gonna do. And then that's it. They might progressively get harder. I don't know. I feel like the bagel's harder than the cookie. But I have other ones that are, like, they're not hard. The last one is just, like, it takes the longest. But it's honestly the easiest out of all of them. But it's not easy if you don't have a certain appliance. Because then you have to, like, makeshift. But we'll get to that. But so yeah, I have a plan for 6 episodes. And yeah. Oh, while, so these just have a few more minutes left. Now you need to preheat the oven to 350. Just because I always forget and then have to wait forever. What do you have to say about the state of our economy? You heard it from her first, folks. Riley on the scene. Okay,
So now that they've rose enough. So now we're gonna form them. So you're gonna take one and then you're gonna pinch a hole. And then I hold it like this and then I shape it kind of like this. It's kind of hard to explain. Just form it into a donut or a bagel. There's one, and then you're just gonna do that for all of them. Okay, so now that you have all your bagels made, you're gonna put the towel back over, like so, like that. And you're just gonna let them sit for 15 minutes, but there's something we're gonna do, and that'll take up the 15 minutes, so just follow. Okay, so now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take like a pot around this size, or you can use bigger, it doesn't matter, and then fill it with water. And then you're gonna turn it on and you're gonna bring it to a boil or like a rolling boil. Just bring it to a boil first. And then you're gonna get I got out a fourth cup of brown sugar. I know how to do this thing where like you tap it a bunch and it flips so that it does this. I do it every time, I don't know why. But so yeah, just have that out. And then so once that comes to a boil, you're gonna add brown sugar to the water, and then you're gonna mix it so it dissolves. And then once that's ready, then the bagels are ready for the next step. I got out my sheets. I'm doing each flavor on a different sheet because I don't wanna risk crossing the flavors because cinnamon jalapeno does not sound good. So yeah. She looks like she's doing like a Superman pose. And yes, I know it's weird to put a jalapeno cheddar bagel into a brown sugar water. But if you don't, it literally comes out like a dinner roll. It is the weirdest consistency. When you boil it, it like, I don't know how to explain it. It just turns it into a bagel. It's like the same process when you make pretzels, you have to do it too. You can't taste it. It just does something to the dough. I know what I'm talking about. Okay, now the water is boiling. So you're gonna turn the heat down to about like medium high so that it doesn't boil. And then you're gonna put that in there and then stir like we're making like a witch's potion. And then give me just a second. Okay, I'm gonna show you how to do the first one and then I'm gonna do the rest and then show you after. So you take a donut, a bagel, and you drop it in the water, and then for 1 minute on one side. So just like count the ABCs, and then so just you can already tell it's like already doing it. Can you see? Yeah. And then now we're gonna flip it over and just do the same amount of time on that side. And then bring a parchment paper close because water will drip. So now that it's done, and they get really big too when they do this, you tap it, get all the water off, and put it on the sheet. And you just do that to all of them. So I'll be back once I'm done. Okay, so now these are all done. They've all been boiled. Now they're ready to be topped. So what you're first going to do is in a bowl, you're going to do one egg and then like a spoonful of water to make an egg wash. You can use milk, but I think water works better. It's all just to make sure that everything like sticks and then everything gets like nice and golden brown. So that's what you want. So I'm just going to do a tiny bit of water. Maybe a little bit more. It's kind of like, it's not at all equal parts, but it's like one part to like a half part. So we're gonna crack our egg. And then I'm just gonna use a spoon. Mix it up.
Okay. Now that you've made your egg wash, you're just gonna take it and you're just gonna carefully just spoon a little bit on to each of them. I might have put just a tiny bit too much, so I'm just spreading it around so that none of the egg cooks, because that would be absolutely disgusting. But okay, now the egg wash is on, and you're gonna have some left over. It's just whatever. Now I'm gonna top them, and then I'll show you what they look like after they're all topped. Okay, so here's the cinnamon crunch. The key kind of is to like really put a lot on there so that it gets like the caramelized and like the crunch, and then there's some down the middle, so we'll do it. And then these are the like everything jalapeno cheddar, and they look so good. Okay, so I put those in for 15 minutes at 350, and then after 15 minutes you switch like the two trays so that they get baked evenly, and then you do it for another 10 to 15. Again, with like the cookies, like it's kind of just how done you want them. I'll show you what mine look like after how long, and then you can add or subtract or whatever. They're done. Look at how good these look. Wow. Wow. But yeah. Those are done. So yeah, so I have 4 more episodes planned. So whenever those get done, they'll get done. Hello. It's fun. I want to go to bed. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. And just watch out for the next one. Bye.